Welcome to Everyday Happiness, where we create lasting happiness in 2 minutes a day through my signature method of intentional margins, creating harmony between your to-dos and your priorities, happiness science, and musings about life. I'm your host, Katie Jeffcoat, and I started my reverse bucket list that we talked about in the last episode. The reverse bucket list is writing a list of your haves and trying to detach yourself from your wants, which is a traditional bucket list, by focusing on the haves, what you already have, what you already have accomplished. So it's also this overtime technique that starts to eliminate the wants. Will that elusive thing really make you happier? For now, I'm keeping it super simple and writing down my haves. Some people might think this is writing down all of the things that they're grateful for. I have this chair in my living room. It brings me so much joy to sit in this chair and sip warm coffee. I have this body that serves me, hands that work, legs that allow me to walk. I have a mind that sees lightness through the dark, that innately searches for the positivity when it feels really hard. I have a family that I am obsessed with, kids who are healthy, a marriage where we prioritize one another, and a husband who is kind and patient and generous and who really loves me. I get to give and receive love with the people that I love most. Those are some of my haves. I've traveled the world to amazing places and had incredible experiences. My haves list is beautiful and long, and it's showing me that my wants are nice, but not what will truly make me happier. I mean, I really want a handbag. Will that make me happier long term? The science already tells me it won't. I have everything I need to be happy right now. So I'm curious if you have had any aha moments when you started writing your haves list, let me know. Let's connect on social at Everyday Happiness with Katie.